गुड मॉर्निंग। ये जजमेंट ऑफ तेलंगाना बाय जस्टिस वी रामसुब्रमण्यम देन वाज नाउ एलिवेटेड टू सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज गिवन ए जजमेंट बाय सिटिंग इन द डिविजन बेंच अलॉन्ग विथ वन पी केशवराव जस्टिस AR 2019 Telangana 53. The case was that Andhra Pradesh State Financial Corporation versus Kotak Mahindra Bank. The case was that the third respondent obtained a loan from State Financial Corporation and willing to treat his debt as pari passu. Actually, what is pari passu means? Pari passu means equal placement. But the doctrine implies that first preference. Suppose you all may know that under Companies Act, shares will have their profit right or loss diminution only after debentures are paid. Debentures means the company which could not run within the prescribed capital may obtain loan by debenture bond. Even that debentures, they will be pari passu list. That means debenture number one, number two, the person who lends loan first or a huge amount will be paid. That is called doctrine of pari passu. In the given case, the third respondent who obtained a loan also obtained a loan from various other banks. One of the bank was subsequently amalgamated with the Kotak Bank. And that respondent who obtained loan from Kotak Bank executed a letter to treat his loan as pari passu, first liability to recover. And there was a letter, a correspondence between the State Finance Corporation and the first respondent bank to treat their loan as pari passu loan. They, according to the first respondent, they say a consent letter was given. But however, the stand of the State Finance Corporation, that letter was not that of the State Finance Corporation. Therefore, the first respondent, Kotak Bank, initiated proceedings under SARFAASI Act, approached the Chief Minister to the Magistrate under the SARFAASI Act and obtained the possession also. And thereafter only the State Finance Corporation, challenging that order, approached the Honorable Andhra Pradesh High Court. In the case, given case, Section 39 of the Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Asset Enforcement Act was discussed and the Section 48 of the Transfer of Property Act was discussed. And finally, the reason for my citing this judgment was the judge said that though there is remedy available under the Revenue Tribunal on appeal, the High Court said because this has got some question of law, certain thing to be decided, we ignore that alternative remedy, and they have allowed it. And finally, some orders, alternative order for compromising between the parties seems to have been given, directing the first respondent to settle the amount with the first finance corporation, then to proceed according to the earlier order. See, this is what periodically the High Courts, some judges deviating the earlier precedent. So the one lesson you should learn was that do not rely that any law was permanently settled. So you try your approach and knock the door of justice if you are capable to do, and dissent with your argument. In per curiam doctrine is also available. In per curiam means if some citations was settled judicial as a judicial precedent, and if you have valid substantial question of law or ignorance of certain area of the law, then you can assail the judgment as in per curiam. So you keep in mind with this and go through the judgment, and the judgment may be useful for the corporate lawyers and the advocates who practice on top level, though it may not be too helpful for the young lawyers. But however, you keep in mind, with this judgment, and you can also cite this judgment whenever you want to approach the Honorable High Court with some prayer, though there is alternative. This will help you. Best wishes.